Good morning, children, and welcome to the class of science. Children, in today's class, we are going to study chapter number 5, Rocks, Minerals, and Soil. And in today's class, children, we are going to talk about the layers of the soil. As we have already completed the topic, rocks and minerals. So let's try to understand the kind of layers, topsoil, subsoil, and bedrock. And what all things they have within. Clear? So we are going to talk about the layers of the soil. And before this, children, you must remember that we have already done about the composition of soil. Here on this page, we are just studying, and I have made the same diagram for you all on the board. So here, children, you have already learned about the composition of soil. Where you have learned, children, soil is made up of gravel, sand, and clay particles, humus, that remains of the dead plants and animals, and water. And children, besides these, soil also contains air, mineral, and some microorganisms. And I hope, children, you all remember the meaning of gravel. I have already told you about that. That is small stones. And children, the meaning of microorganism, I have already shared with you all. A very small living thing that can be only seen under a microscope. So here we are moving ahead with the topic, the layers of the soil, which has already been shown in your textbook here, right here on this page. So let's try to understand, children, layers of the soil. Children, soil can be divided into three main layers. First layer name is topsoil. Here you can see the topsoil where I have drawn all these things. So let us see, children, what all things are there in the topsoil. It contains fine particles of sand and clay, humus and air. And children, the topsoil gives most of the nutrients needed by the plants to grow. So here, children, you can see the topsoil where I have drawn the plants are growing and they are able to get nutrients needed by the plants from the top soil. So in all, children, you have come to know the meaning of humus. What is the meaning of humus, children? Remains of dead plants and animals. Do not forget, because this is a new word for you all. So what is the meaning of humus? Remains of dead plants and animals. So in all, children, you have come to know about the top soil, that it contains fine particles of sand, clay. Sand and clay is present here. Humus, I have already told you, remains of dead plants and animals, and air. And children, apart from this, the topsoil gives most of the nutrients needed by the plants to grow. So here we are able to see the roots are going down to absorb the nutrients from the soil. All the plants are having their own roots in the topsoil and trying to absorb the nutrients from the topsoil. Children, next layer of the soil is subsoil. Children, it is the layer below the topsoil. It is below the topsoil. As you can see, first layer is the topsoil, the other layer is the subsoil. So you can say the second layer is the layer below the topsoil and contains pieces of rock and water. What it is containing, children? Pieces of rock and water. Here you can see pieces of rock and water in this subsoil. Children, the roots of some big trees grow down into the subsoil. As here I have drawn the small plants, if there are some big trees, big plants, they will be, their roots will be going deep down in the subsoil. Because they are big and their roots are spreading all over in the subsoil. Dear children, so once again, try to understand, what do you mean by subsoil? It is the layer below the topsoil and contains pieces of rock and water. This is containing pieces of rock and water. And children, just remember, the roots of some big trees grow down into the subsoil. Here, the roots of the some of the big trees are growing here. Next, children, we talk about the third layer, that is the bedrock. What is the name of the third layer? the bedrock. It is made up of large pieces of rock. As here you can see, the large pieces of rock being drawn on the board, you can observe and see. There is not much water here. And children, there is not much of water available here on this bedrock area. It is quite deep inside the earth. As you can see, we are having the topsoil at the first. Second layer is the subsoil. And then comes the bedrock, which is having good amount of rocks in this area. So it is quite deep inside the earth, children. So in all, you have come to know what all layers are there. Three layers are there, which are also shown in your textbook, as I have drawn here the diagram, just very similar to the one which is given in your textbook. I can bring it to closer to you all to make you understand and see and observe what all areas are being shown here. The first layer, children, it is the topsoil, then the subsoil, then the bedrock. So here you can observe the kind of layers being shown of the soil. So in this way, children, you are able to understand each and everything about the layers of the soil, which you have learned in my class today. So once again, children, try to remember that the soils are divided into three layers of soil. One is the topsoil, second one is the subsoil, third one is the bedrock. And children, bedrock would be having large amount of rocks in this. So in this way, children, you are able to understand the three kinds of layers of the soil and what all things are being present in the topsoil, subsoil and bedrock. In all, you have come to know that topsoil, it contains fine particles of sand and clay, humus and air. And children, on the topsoil, only the roots of some plants are absorbing and it is helpful for their growth, as they are being provided with the kind of nutrients they need. Then in the subsoil, children, it is the layer below the topsoil and contains pieces of rock. As you can see, pieces of rock are being drawn here. These are the rocks. Okay? And water as well. Water is also present in the subsoil. And children, do not forget, the roots of some big trees grow down into the subsoil. The roots of the big trees go in the subsoil area. Then you have come to know about the bedrock, children. That is, it is made of large pieces of rocks. Here you can see, again I am telling you, large pieces of rocks. And there is not much water here. Remember this. So it is quite deep inside the earth. And lastly, children, do not forget the meaning of humus, which I have shared with you in this class today. That means remains of dead plants and animals. So I hope, children, you have come to know about all the three layers of the soil. That is the topsoil, subsoil and the bedrock. Here you can just observe what all things are there in the subsoil and the bedrock. So I hope, children, you are able to understand each and everything about the layers of the soil in my class today. And try to remember what all I have explained to you in my class today. That's all for my class today, children. Thank you and have a nice day. Take care. Bye-bye for now.